गुड आफ्टरनून डियर स्टूडेंट्स। Okay, today I am going to discuss about the use of excipients in the cosmetic formulations. These are the some additives. A list of additives which is used in the cosmetic formulations. For example, is emollient, waxes, oils, humectant, preservatives, binders, surfactants, colors, perfumes, and the herbals. These are the list of some additives which is, or we can call as a excipient, which is used in the preparations of cosmetic formulations. The role of different excipient or additives in the cosmetic formulation is different in different formulations. There's a different requirement of additives to formulate and cosmetic products. Okay, so today we will discuss some additives and their properties in brief. Okay, in that first I am going to discuss about this ideal properties of humectants, types and examples and its definition. Okay, so before that, some properties of this humectant. By drying of cosmetics may due to when we have to use the different formulations and we kept or we forget to cap these formulations. So whatever the additives which is present into the formulations may get dried. Okay, so drying of cosmetics may due to because of first is the vaporization of water. So the first reason why these cosmetics are dried. So first reason is the vaporization of water. Second thing is the depends on the temperature, degree of exposure to air and the relative humidity in the air. So these are the some reasons. Because of these reasons, the cosmetic formulations are dry off. Okay, so therefore we have to add this humectant in this different type of formulations to prevent the drying of cosmetics, we are using these additives, and these additives are called as the humectant. Okay, so which are the humectants which is used in the formulations? Most of them are hygroscopic material. So what is the hygroscopic material? The material which can absorb the moisture from the environment is called as an hygroscopic material. Okay, so what is the purpose of addition? This is also the part of humectant. Why this is added into the formulations? We have different type of formulations. Okay, in that we are added the additives as a humectant. So what is the purpose of this type of formulations? It is used to reduce the loss of moisture. So therefore we are added the humectants into the formulations. Used to keep cream soft. If in that type of formulations, in the cream vanishing cream, for example, this type of formulations, if we are added the humectant, the role of the humectant is, if some water has been loose or moisture has been loose from that type of formulations, the consistency of this formulation, what is consistency, what is the requirement, the cream may feel a soft, this feeling of softness is get decreases. So therefore these humectants are added into the such type of formulations. Okay, so second purpose is use this humectant is used to give your cream soft. Example is vanishing cream. Okay, and in simultaneously this humectant possesses the emollient actions that is also maintained with the help of these humectants, and this also forms a thin film on the skin when applied. Okay, with the formulation which is applied on the skin, it leaves a thin film on the skin, and it also influences the structure conditions of the skin, and all moisturizing preparation contains the humectants. In this summer season, there is a number of preparations which is used, and these formulations are also consist of the humectant. Because of the properties of this type of material that can absorb the moisture from the environment, and also it reduces the loss of moisture from their formulations or from the skin surfaces. So therefore water content, if you want to maintain the water container from on the skin, so in this type of formulations we are using humectant. Okay, not only the humectants are responsible to over the drying of product, but also based on the container enclosure in which it is packed. Okay, whether it is a wide mouth container or different types of containers, openings of container. So humectants are responsible which type of closures we are used for that packaging of these formulations. These problems are also affect on the drying of product. Okay, but this is one of the additives which is plays the important role in the stability of formulations, and because of addition of this humectant into the different type of formulations, it gives the special feeling to the skin also. The properties of these hygroscopic materials are also that must absorb the moisture. I was already discussed the properties of this humectant is it should must absorb the moisture from the environment and therefore the proportion of the water or moisture in the skin is also maintained. So therefore we have to use this humectant applied on the skin surfaces to prevent drying of the skin, okay, and should causes a little changes only in water content with the change in relative humidities within the normal relative humidity range, okay. And this type of materials are also compatible with other material, means humectants are compatible with the other materials. Colorless, the properties of humectant is good odor and taste. It should having non-toxic and non-irritant. It is non-corrosive to packaging material, means it does not change the physical properties or chemical properties of this packaging material. Not solidified or crystallized at the normal conditions. Some excipients may get solidified or crystallized as change in the temperature or atmospheric conditions, okay. So it should not solidify or crystallize at the normal conditions. These additives not to be too costly. The viscosity and the relative curves should be relatively flat, okay. Three classes of humectants are there. The first class is the inorganic, second class is metal organic, third one is organic, okay. Humectants has been classified into these three categories: inorganic, then metal organics, and then organics. Examples of some humectants, that is calcium chloride. The properties of calcium chloride is also having, that is absorb the moisture from the environment, okay. So that's why we will take the example. So disadvantages of this type of humectant, that is compatibility problem, then corrosive natures. This is one of the two disadvantages of this calcium chloride. This type of calcium chlorides are having the limited use in the cosmetics. Next is the sodium lactate. What are the advantages and the disadvantages and details? The properties of this sodium lactate is having greater hygroscopic power than the glycerin. Then disadvantages of this type of sodium lactate is having, it should have in the compatibility problem, corrosive nature, and pronounced state. These are the some disadvantages associated with sodium lactate. Generally, sodium lactate is used in the skin cream as no risk of toxicity. Admixtures of sodium lactate plus lactic acid is used to overcome the pH problems. This sodium lactate, which is having limited use in the cosmetic formulations as an additives or as an humectants. Okay, and the some humectants are listed over here. Polyhydric alcohols, their esters in the ethers. Okay, the basic categories of these humectants and widely used in cosmetics. And below that, they listed some commonly used humectants. Ethylene glycol, propylene glycol, polyethylene glycols, glycerol, sorbitol 22 and 23, polyethylene oxide, polyoxyethylene. This is available in varying molecular weights based on the concentration, and effectiveness is depends. We have the number of polyethylene glycol derivatives. For example, is polyethylene 400 is also available in our laboratories store, and polyethylene glycol 4000, which is also available. So why the name is given that PEG 400 and PEG 4000? What are the difference between these two? Why name is given PEG 400? Because molecular weight of this PEG is 400 Daltons, so therefore grade is PEG 400. If PEG 4000 is there, then the molecular weight of this polyethylene glycol is a 4000 Dalton. Okay, depending on, we have to grading the polyethylene glycols. So these are the some most commonly used at humectants in the cosmetic formulations: PEG, polypropylene glycols, polyethylene glycols, glycerol, sorbitol, etc. Again, this one is diethylene glycol, triethylene glycols, tripropylene glycols, polyoxyethylene glycerol, glycerin, xylitol, mannitol, sorbitol, polyoxyethylene sorbitol, glucose, triethylamine, triethylamine lactate, urea, etc. The next is surfactant. What we was discussed, that is a some list of these humectants which is used in the cosmetic formulations. The next is the surfactant. As you know that the surfactant is a material which reduces the surface tension of water. That is surfactant. Okay, as all of you are knows very well about this, but these surfactants are widely used in the different formulations. If you want to prepare a cosmetics by emulsification method, at that time surfactant plays an important role for emulsification. If you want to prepare the shampoos in the various formulations, there is also requirement of surfactant. Our bath soap is also having the surfactant. Toothpaste, in that toothpaste, in some formulations which is used in the limited quantities, means whatever the quantities which is given in various pharmacopoeias, in this type of formulations the surfactants are used. So we will discuss what is surfactant. Surfactant are compound that stabilize the mixtures of oil and water by reducing the surface tension at the interface between the oil and water molecules. So that's why these surfactants are used in the preparations of emulsions as an emulsifiers. Okay, again, the surfactants are compound that stabilize the mixture of oil and water by reducing the by decreasing the surface tension at the interface between the oil and water molecules is called as an surfactant. Okay, so what are the surfactants? What we will call as surfactants? Surfactants are amphiphilic in nature. Amphi, which means double, amphiphiles is equal to the double affinity as a polar and a polar duality. Means this surfactant is having the affinity towards the polar as well as non-polar compounds, non-polar substances. Okay, so therefore the surfactants are used in the formulations of emulsions as well as emulsification process for the various types of cosmetic formulations. Hydrophilic is equal to the lipophobe, and which is having the polar in natures and having a high affinity. Hydrophobe is equal to the lipophile, which is non-polar in natures, and because of this alkyl chain is present. Okay, and this is the structural representation of this surfactant: polar, hydrophilic head, and the non-polar hydrophobic tail. Okay, this is head is having the water-loving properties, while this tail is having the water-hitting properties. So therefore, we are saying that this surfactant possesses the two groups. One is polar and second is the non-polar. Because of this head is having the water-loving properties, or this is having the more affinity towards the water phase, and this tail is having the more affinity towards the non-polar phases. Okay, so tail or hydrophobic groups, which has little affinity for water, this groups is usually a hydrocarbon or alkyl chain one. Okay, then head or hydrophilic groups, which has the strong affinity for water and can be neutral or charged one. Okay, this is the properties of head and the tail one. The primary performance functions of surfactant is the lowering of interfacial tensions. The main purpose of this surfactant are also called as the we can call as a surfactant means what? Surface active material. Okay, as we was discussed in the physical pharmaceutics, in the pharmaceutics one, that the performance, the use of this surfactant is also called as the surface active material, which is act on the surface of oil and the water interfaces. Okay, so primary performance functions of the surfactant is the lowering of interfacial tension. Some examples are there. The use of the surfactant in the different formulations. The first one is cleansing properties. What are the cleansing properties? How the dirt has been removed from the surface of clothes. Okay, different detergents is present. The detergent powder, there is the one important ingredient which is used in the detergent, that is the surfactant, because it should produce the foam and also having the ability to reduce the surface tension or to decrease or lower the surface tension of water or surface tension of this one. So lowering the tension between the dirt and oil, water and your skin or hair. Okay, when we are using or we are work on the oil, your hand is completely soaked with the oil at that time. You want to remove the oil from the hands or palms. At that time, we are using soap. The purpose of soap is cleansing of this or removal of the oil or dirt which is present on your skin. So the purpose of disinfectant is first is the primary functions is the cleansing, and how it is cleansed, lowering the tension between the oil and the water and your skin or hair. Okay, so we will easily remove whatever the dirt which is present on the cloth and which is also present on the hair. So second type of performance function, that is the emulsions. In the various types of emulsions, we are using surfactant. Without the surfactant, emulsions cannot be prepared. We cannot finish this. Okay. So lowering the tension between the oil phase and water phase is takes place with the help of emulsion. Okay. Third one is dispersions, lowering the tension between the particles and water and oil. So in that type of formulations, in the suspensions, if the whatever the drug which is not dispersed on the dispersion medium, which is float on the surface of this water, that can be dispersed with the help of surfactant. Okay, when we have to add the surfactant in water, the surface tension of water is get decreases, and therefore the insoluble solids has been easily dispersed into that dispersion medium. Classification of surfactants. First one is anionic surfactants, mostly soap, sulfonates and sulfates. Second is the non-ionic surfactants, mostly ethoxylated fatty acid esters. Third one is cationic surfactants, in that mostly quaternary ammoniums is used as surfactant. Fourth one is amphoteric or zwitter ions, or we can call as a zwitter ions ionics, mostly betaines and the amino acid derivatives is used as an amphoteric surfactant. Okay, these are the four classifications of the surfactant: anionic, non-ionic, cationic and amphoteric. New classes of surface active substances are also available nowadays. This polymer surfactant or surface active polymers. Second one is the silicon surface. Term is silicophilic, silicon loving and the silicophobic, silicon hating. This is the another newer classes of surfactants. Surfactant and criteria for personal cares or household product formulations. Where it should be used, what is the purpose of the uses of the surfactant in the different household formulations and the different cosmetic preparations. Applications depending on household, in the skincare formulations, body care, hair care formulations. Okay. Second is the category of the surfactant criteria for personal care: primary, secondary, and tertiary. Permeability of the surfactant, which is foam booster, and some of them which is used as anti-foaming agents. Level of irritant. Some surfactants are irritant. For example, is cationic and anionics. This are produces the irritations. So therefore, according to its level of irritant, irritant mild, very mild. Okay, so the order is mildness. Non-ionics is having the less or low retention rate as compared with the amphoteryx. Amphoteryx is having the low amphoteric, low irritant properties as compared with the anionic, and anionic is having the low irritation rate as compared with this cationic. So which one is the higher irritant properties? Cationic surfactant is having the more irritant properties, and which one is lower irritation rate? Non-ionic. So most of the formulations, depending on the requirement, we are using the non-ionic surfactant and the anionic surfactant as compared with this cationic surfactant. Okay, depending on its uses, we have to incorporate the different type of surfactant in the cosmetic formulation. Next one is the form characters, which type of bubbles we require on that basis, big bubbles, small bubbles, or dense bubble. In that basis, we have to use the different type of surfactants. After fill effect, once you are using these formulations, which is made up of surfactant, you are feel dried, soft, powdery feel, etc. Okay. The seventh one is the electrolyte responses as a thickening agent or thickening effect, cloudy, sometimes no effect. Okay. Last one is level of concentration, which is permitted into the different type formulation, which is reported into the handbook of excipients. According to that, we have to use the different concentration of surfactant in the different type of cosmetic formulations. Okay, today we will discuss till the this criteria for personal care and household product formulations. And after tomorrow we will discuss on the remaining additives or excipient use in the cosmetic formulation. Thank you, dear students, for your attendance.